Thomas Hayes, AW1. I got out in 1980 for about a month. I got out in November or September of 1980. In January of 1981, I joined BP9. I came back into the reserves, and I served with BP93 over in Detroit. BP93, reserve BP. They're a little bit different world because you're land based and you're pretty well tight knit. I was with them for 13 years, flying as a radar operator in P3s, Orions, Alphas, and Bravos. And from there, they decommissioned the squadron. I went to a TSC, which is a tactical support center, and for about a year. And then a friend of mine called me up and said, "Hey, VP64 in Willow Grove, Pennsylvania was looking for radar operators." I said, "Well, if you can pick me up, I'll go up." And the radar school was very good. Did it out of Willow Grove. And from there, we flew quite a few missions as far as, because it was Cold War, tracking subs. A lot of times you have 14-hour flights. Helicopters, you had the dipping sonar, and you didn't have quite grams, so you transmit all your signals to a ship and then they go through it, which normally we wouldn't see. But on board the plane, on the P3, it was quite impressive on how you could read that. And I was, in my equipment being, I was a radar operator or electronic surveillance, it birds, infrared cameras, ESM, which is spotting other radars that are out there, and magnetic anomaly detector. We did SAR missions. We did have a mission out of Puerto Rico where they had we got a signal for a ship that was in distress, and it was off the Canary Islands. So we flew 8 hours out, or no, it was like 7 hours out, turned the radar on, found the ship. They were without power, and the only communications we had was a handheld. So we stayed there till the Coast Guard got overhead and watched them so we could get CTOW back. And we were involved with the Adriatic blockade when things were going on in Yugoslavia with the Serbs. And we went from there, we went over to, we were involved with the Haiti blockade. So spotting ships going out and then didn't send in Coast Guards or Customs or whatever, take care of the refugees that were trying to get off the island. And they had, I was with them for 4 years until I retired in 1997. So I did get a medal for the rescues that I did, the Naval Marine Corps medal.